Dear all, in this video we are going to see the topic CDMA 2000. Let's have a detailed explanation on its radio network and network components. Let's get into the video. Code Division Multiple Access 2000 is a third generation standard developed by ITU. This protocol uses CDMA access to send voice and data and signals between mobile phones and cell sites. It is developed under the project 3GPP2 and the partnership consisting of 5 telecommunication standards bodies, data communication speeds ranging from 114 kilobits per second to 2 megabits per second are supported by this standard. CDMA 2000 is unique in such a way that it supports 3G services and also it enables a logical migration from the existing 2G platforms to 3G without disturbing the legacy system. Legacy system means the traditional systems. CDMA 2000 is also known as IMT multi-carrier or IS2000 or IMT2000MC multi-carrier. These are the 3G applications supported by CDMA 2000. And we have various migrations of CDMA 2000. CDMA 2000 1X and 1X EVDO, 1X EVDV, CDMA 2000 3X. Let's see one by one in detail. CDMA 2000 1X. The evolution of CDMA 2000 1X is labeled CDMA 2000 1X EV. 1X EV will be implemented in two steps. 1X EVDO and 1X EVDV. DO stands for data only and DV stands for data and voice. Both standard uses 1.25 MHz carrier. 1X EVDO probably will be available for CDMA 2000 operators during the year of 2002 and 1X EVDV solutions will be available approximately in the late 2003 or early 2004. CDMA 2003X. It is a part of multi-carrier technology. It uses less than 5 MHz spectrum to give speeds of over 2 megabits per second. Radio and network components. CDMA 2000, whether 1X or 3X, it requires upgrades to the radio and network architecture of the existing system. This is the system architecture of CDMA 2000. Here, each and every network component should be explained. See, PDSN stands for Packet Data Serving Node. The purpose of PDSN is to support packet data services. The major functions performed by PDSN are it establishes, maintains and terminates point-to-point protocol sessions with the subscriber. It supports both simple and mobile IP packet services. And it routes packets to and from the external packet data networks. And then this AAA. AAA server is another new component associated with CDMA 2000 deployment. It provides authentication, authorization and accounting functions for the packet data network associated with CDMA 2000 and utilizes the remote access dial-in user service protocol, that is RADIUS, RADIUS. And then the home agent. Home agent is another major component to CDMA 2000. The major function performed by the home agent is to track the location of mobile IP. And then router. The router is responsible for sending and receiving packets to and from the internal network to the off-net platforms. And also, a firewall is required to ensure that the security is maintained when connecting to off-net data applications. And major functions performed by router are, it has to route the packets to and from the various network elements within the CDMA 2000. And then, home location register. The HLR needs to store additional subscriber information associated with the introduction of packet data services. The service information from the HLR is downloaded in the visitor location register, that is called VLR, of the associated network switch during the successful registration process. Then BTS, Base Transceiver Station. BTS is responsible for allocating resources and both power and voltage codes for consumption by the subscribers. Base Station Controller. BSE is responsible for controlling all the base transceiver station, that is called BTS, under its domain. The BSE routes packets to and from the BTS to the PDSN. BSE also routes time division multiplexing traffic to the circuit switched platforms, and it routes packet data to the PDSN. The network structure for a CDMA 2000 system supports 2.5G and 3G, has all the traditional voice elements associated with 2G wireless voice systems. The packet network is often called the IP network. There are three main variants in configuring a CDMA 2000 network. First one, distributed, second one, regional, and the third one is centralized approach. So the selection of variants is based on the service supported, the traffic volume, location of PDSN, commercial interconnection agreements, network reliability and availability. See, this is the architecture of distributed network. The distributed network is ideal for a wireless company that has only a few markets that are geographically dispersed. This is the architecture of the distributed network. Here, the advantages of a distributed network is its simple implementation. The distributed architecture can also be folded at a later time into a regional or centralized approaches. That means the other two approaches. The disadvantage is with the distributed approach, that is the issue of duplication and the lack of economics of scale for implementing and operating the network. And the second type, regional network, it manages the segmented market from one localized point, and this configuration is extensible. The segregation of different vendor platforms are possible. And the disadvantages, the networks may not be designed and managed the same way, leads to the classic issue of two networks run by the same company but having different design goals and performance. And this is the third approach. The advantages are the management of various markets and systems from a centralized location. Here you could see in the diagram, the centralized network components will control all the elements present in the network. And it can be migrated easily from a regional structure based system. Disadvantages are local market flexibility will be lost, and backbone transport size may become unwieldy, that is too large to organize.